Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX posted some information about the report they submitted to the FAA for the Starlink flight issue. They said the SpaceX team submitted our report to the FAA regarding Falcon 9's launch anomaly, including likely cause and associated corrective actions. They also posted a page on their website with more information about what caused the second stage issue. They said, during the first burn of Falcon 9's second stage engine, a liquid oxygen leak developed within the insulation around the upper stage engine. The cause of the leak was identified as a crack in a sense line for a pressure sensor attached to the vehicle's oxygen system. This line cracked due to fatigue caused by high loading from engine vibration and looseness in the clamp that normally constrains the line. SpaceX have now returned Falcon 9 to flight with their 70th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 10-9.
1-0.
The boost which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 17th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deployed.
Then this morning, SpaceX also successfully launched their 72nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 10-4. The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas. Later this morning, SpaceX also successfully launched their 73rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 9-4.
1, ignition, and lift off Falcon 9, go direct to cell, SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 17th time on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a couple of Falcon launches. The first of these, the Starlink 10-6 mission, is currently scheduled for Friday, August 2nd at 4:19 a.m. UTC or 12:19 a.m. EST. Then the following day, and we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The NG-21 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 3rd at 3:28 p.m. UTC or 11:28 a.m. EST. Related to the first Starlink mission that happened today, SpaceX posted some information. They said our 300th free flight of a booster delivers 23 Starlink satellites to low Earth orbit. Related to the Starliner incident, Eric Berger posted some information. He said, it's clear NASA does not want to deviate from its base plan of using Starliner to come home, and this remains most likely, but it is not certain. SpaceX and NASA have been quietly studying launching Crew 9 2 astronauts. Suits are available for Butch and Sunny. Jeff Faust posted some other information about crew missions on Dragon. It says NASA announced at a Crew 9 briefing that Crew 10 is now scheduled to launch next February, with Starliner 1 moving to next August to give more time for reviews after the CFT mission. Heading to Boca Chica, concrete was seen being installed at the base of Launch Tower 2. The fourth module for the orbital Pad B tower was seen lifted and stacked. The fifth module for the second launch tower was moved to the launch site. Work was seen going on inside Mega Bay 2. During the week, Starship 30 performed a full-duration static fire test at Massey's test site. SpaceX posted a couple of pictures of the Starship 30 vehicle. They said full-duration static fire of Flight 5 Starship. They also posted a cool slow-motion video of the static fire test of Starship 30 as they prepare for Flight 5. here's a look at the work on the nose of Starship 33 in the high bay. To finish up the video today, let's take a quick look at the Cameron County website. SpaceX currently have a temporary road closure for tomorrow, Monday 29th to Tuesday 30th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Jack Beyer and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.